Hello everybody and welcome to another episode of Red Dead Redemption 2 Story. Last episode we ended off killing a cougar and all that fun junk. But now let's go see what other fun things we could do, shall we? We should look at that. There's a train here. Sir?
Hello there, pleased to see you.
I need a train ticket.
Pleasant travels.
Gracias. Alright, get up, Arthur. There we go. Hello, Jose. Alright, we're gonna get out of here before.
Come on, pal.
Before we get any witnesses, we need to go.
Hey, who's there?
Arthur, dumbass.
Arthur.
Anything about us?
No, we was just locals, local problem. Fella I used to know.
Okay. Well, would you please try to keep away from old people while we're getting this much attention?
I understand, boss. And I'm sorry for being foolish. It was an old thing, and my emotions got the better of
me. Hello.
Yes, kid. You got a lot on?
Just hunting for all this hillbilly gold that Dutch and Hosea seem to think is out there just waiting to be stolen. Why?
I got something. Could be good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I was in Rhodes talking to some of the colored folk. They said there's a gang of fools holed up in the swamps east of here who think they war ain't never ended.
The Civil War?
Yeah, apparently it's still raging in these fools' minds 30 years later.
Okay.
That ain't my point. These ignorant fools are weapon dealers. And in their dealings, sometimes sit on a decent pile of cash. Yeah, been selling weapons to Cuba and South America for years. Anyway, the old boy I was talking to reckon there might be a bunch of cash just sitting around. And failing that, maybe a nice stash of weapons.
Just a bunch of crazies guarding it?
Exactly.
Well, worth taking a look at least, isn't it?
That was my thinking. Said it was at some place called Shady Bear, deep in the woods.
Okay.
I was hoping you'd be in. If it's how they told it, it's gonna be something all right.
We'll see.
Hey, Charles.
You don't make a convincing lawman.
So, Uncle, don't say it. I know I messed up.
Okay, fella.
Come on. It's this way. On me.
You spoken a Dutch since you got back?
Yes.
Okay, Lennon, let's get moving.
You know,
where is John?
I've met these crazies before.
You been drinking again?
No. Well, yes, but no, that's not how I might have met them. I think some of them harangued me and Sadie when we were coming back with supplies.
Mrs. Adler?
Yeah. And Mrs. Adler did just fine. More than fine, actually. She's terrified. But I got a notion these fellas is one and the same.
Yeah, we won't find no shortage of angry Peckerwood idiots in the state of Lemoyne. That's for sure.
Is it really that different in this state? We haven't come far.
It seems like it is.
These boys got a manner about them, but I haven't necessarily noticed.
All respect, Mr. Morgan. You wouldn't notice. Might call you a nigger lover. They see us riding like this. But most of it is a glance or a word. And after that, a visit in the night.
Well, out west, it's...
Out west is out west. And you're all who you are.
Right.
Decent folks. But some places down here, they judge different.
Well, then, I guess it can't be so easy for you, Lenny. Sorry you're caught up in this.
Well, I guess their gold's still shining, and their guns still shooting. So I'm game for robbing any and every one of these bastards for all they got.
Okay, then.
Plus, it beats being lynched back in Blackwater with all of you by my side.
I guess it does.
What is wrong with you? Jim Bob, get up. You were saying, Lenny?
Feels like we're close. It's a rundown old plantation house. Down in the bayou somewhere.
Let's take it slow. Be cautious. If, like you say, these crazies are sitting on weapons, we're gonna wanna strategize a little before getting shot at.
Of course. They said find the old battlefield and keep on going.
Yeah, I've been here before. I can see the wrecked old Civil War weaponry. Where are the wrecked old Civil War holdouts?
See that church up ahead? They're supposed to use it as an outpost. Heard they got men going between here and the big house all day.
Okay.
Look at this field. Imagine getting caught up in a fight like this.
Yeah, I don't care to. those reins in. Let's just take a look around the place.
Where we're going's close, but you'll need a mount.
So, you were saying?
I hear you. It doesn't look like anyone's here.
We don't know that for sure.
Something if you're gonna stop, okay? Hear that? Someone's on the track. Look there, the wagon.
Let's see where he's going. You're on me now.
Right behind.
Let's keep our distance. Just two fellas out on the road.
Wait, what?
I think I see something. End of the avenue, between the trees.
Might be it. Might be. Keep it steady.
Hey, big plantation house. Must be Shady Bend. I reckon we can leave our mounts up there, off the trail.
Good enough to me.
Can I hitch my horse on this tree?
Are we doing this? Come on. We can get a view on them from that wall up there. Bring your sighted rifle, okay? I'll take the other side. You get in cover there. Did you see anything?
No. Yes. Yeah. They're here, all right. And they're armed. Almost a militia.
I know dynamite crates when I see them.
We got something, right?
Oh, we got something. We can hit them head on, fight them honest. Or you could go down there acting friendly.
Friendly? With these folks?
Just draw them into one spot, then I'll start shooting.
Well, that might be the dumbest idea I've ever heard. But hey, I'm always up for a performance. You gonna make a call?
Gonna hit him head on. You say you play acting for Jose and the girls.
Fine by me. As soon as you shoot, I'll go.
Let's go.
Not yet.
This one looks good. Search it.
Here.
Come on.
This is full of new rifles.
We can sell those, right?
We sure can. We'll check the rest later. Now, come on. Let's go.
Let's go, let's go. Get this back to camp. Yep.
Yep.
We better watch that dynamite.
We need to get these back. Come on. G up. Fall in.
Hey, riders, coming our way.
Okay, keep a cool head.
What's the black feller doing coming out of Shady Bell? In one of our wagons?
We was doing some business with your brothers back there.
You don't look like any kind of folk we deal with. You look just the opposite. The goddamn sheriff.
Anyone chasing us?
I should think we're out of the woods then, so to speak.
Boy, oh boy.
You did good.
We did it.
Well, let's get to camp before saying anything like that.
I know Sean's been bringing in quite a lot lately, and I wanted to... It's good to have something to show like this.
Sean's a loudmouth bragging. Don't worry about what Sean does.
Hey, I like him, you know?
Well, so do I. That's my better judgment. Just, you worry about you. He wasn't on Leviticus Cornwall's train with me. We had to dig him out of Blackwater.
But...
There's no but nothing. Me and Dutch, and everyone who counts, we know what you do for this gang. We notice. Keep it up. You're gonna start seeing things change for you.
Okay, then. Okay. Thank you, Arthur.
Yep.
Hey, the camp's in these trees up here.
Let's get there.
Arthur, Lenny, coming back.
These are fine rifles.
Right?
I'm gonna keep one, just for me. Hey, I always enjoy riding with you, kid.
You know how to fight.
Hey, you too. Anytime, Arthur.
Well, this is like one of the best rifles in the game. Right, the bolt action? Alright, we've done our things, now let's go. Let's go help Abigail. Or, I don't know if she needs help. But everyone does.
I don't think this law disguise is cool with anyone. Hey, Arthur.
What's going on?
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said you knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Hosea wants you to join him instead. Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
Let me treat it with some respect and affection. All them out there, they're laughing at me.
You think this is the way to a man's affection? Moping and pestering all the damn time?
can do a lot worse than that.
Is that a threat? Another great way to a man's affection.
Oh, shut up.
Gladly.
Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan.
This is not what I want to deal with right now, okay?
Why does it do that? So I'm going to settings. Oh. Okay, then right over.
My God, you're ridiculous.
You think you're a lawman now, do you?
Calm down.
No one thinks it's funny, Morgan.
Come here, horsey. So I'm at neutral honor. I need to get that up. Yes, Hosea? John! Mr. Marston. John Marston's by far my favorite character.
Selling it back to where it came from.
That's not Arthur.
I ain't got a market for it. They made it. They must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So, what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses, and all I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. Okay. Ooh, she's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please.
Maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's out. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it.
Whoa. Relax, I ain't here to rob you.
Oh, it seems that's easy enough. Why don't do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
Dollar a bottle.
You give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward. Finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it.
least not without orders.
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
Get out of the way.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me. Yeah.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing, Tristan. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward. Just a bit. A squint.
Oh, perfect. What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot.
Uh-oh. I killed the dude's horse. He was completely fine. Oh, man. That sucks. Oh, I guess we're all the way back here.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah. That don't surprise me. Yeah.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing, Tristan. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward. Just a bit. Squint.
Oh, perfect. What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot.
Right? Broke poor Mammy's heart. There, there. Fenton, there, there. Don't get mad now.
Try not to run anybody over.
keep it and stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so.
Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me.
Rick's dumb.
Gentlemen! Gentlemen! Quite the town you have here. We just rode in from up north.
Hey.
Hello! Hello, I'm Melvin. This is my brother Fenton. Don't mind him. Don't mind him.
He's turned idiot. Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour?
Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor. Gentlemen, my name is Melvin. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Now come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas.
I'll have one, Ben.
Three drinks. A gift. Bounty. It's a sin to look a gift horse in the mouth. When I see a gift horse, I'm
like, that's some strong stuff.
Just keep them coming.
Sin will catch us all. So drink up.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Ben, open another bottle. Where is he, boys? Don't be shy, it's the land of opportunity. Now
you're fine, man. You're fine, man. Don't listen to your brother.
We got work to do, my
over
boys.
Here, Finn. Go.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Quiet libation.
You.
Me?
You're the bastards who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Gentlemen, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him!
Those bastards from Shady.
We run the liquor around here. Stay the hell out of our business.
What the heck? Dude. Oh, Jose attack?
Let's go. us out of here.
Ain't gonna let this go, are they?
Over there! They got a...
Can't wait to hear...
That's him dealt with.
You pair of bastards!
Behind us, Arthur! Coming out of the alley!
We run the lick around here!
Jeez.
Pick up a career in, what was it?
Advertising.
You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Mob Braithwaite. See what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
I'll go speak to Dutch. So, what do you think?
About what?
Fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold. And in the middle of it all, you got some... inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something ain't nobody gonna know we was here. Because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them, or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
How the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side.
and then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done, and not the other lot, we'll be long gone. Think of it as payback for my daddy.
Payback? I ain't in the revenge business, Dutch. Least of all for something happened a long time ago.
Well, I guess we all gotta pay for something. Now, if you will excuse me, Arthur, I got to write a letter.
Dang, bro. I was really into it. That was nuts. You know what? Let's go help Dutchy boy.
Arthur.
Yes, I'll save. I'll see what happens if I ignore him. I'm just about to just like stand here.
What now? You sweating yet, Dutch?
Of course I'm sweating. We're in some disease-ridden, swampy, Dixie-whistling shithole.
I meant about what Trelawney said about these bounty hunters.
Well, not sweating as such, but maybe a little gentle perspiration. Until we know more, ain't too much harm in wasting good liquor on sweating.
So?
I think you should pay Mr. Trelawney a visit and find out exactly what he knows and who he spoke to. Take Charles with you. Oh, the sight of the pair of you would make a statue sing out its secrets.
Okay.
Charles?
I need you for some business in town. Come on.
Okay.
Between us and that mess now, I ain't seen no more Pinkertons for a while. There's these bounty hunters, of course, but Dutch don't seem too worried about it.
Can't believe they're still coming after us. We didn't even get away with the money.
Yeah, but they don't know that.
Of course. Trelawney. I've only met him a couple times, but he's a strange one.
It's that one with the fire outside.
Let's take a look.
Shit. This don't look so good.
What?
We clearly ain't here, so where is it?
Let's take a look around.
This food barely touched. Looks like he left in a hurry.
Let me grab that hair pomade.
Someone got here first.
Let me take the hair pomade. Thank you.
By the looks of things, it wasn't a suit.
Check the house.
Let me inspect the coop.
That ain't good.
bread's not made, so he must have been here recently.
Big struggle. Pretty recently, I'd say. I guess maybe 12 hours ago.
But no body?
Not yet. Look, tracks. Come on.
Giddy up.
They went down the path here. How's your tracking these days?
All right, I guess.
Well, lead the way then.
Not the kind of place I'd expect to see Trelawney staying in.
No?
Normally scams himself into the best hotel in town.
You know, when me and Javier went down with Trelawney to get Sean, after the bar fight, I swear, he talked the whole way and never actually said a damn thing.
I thought you knew. That's his special talent. They could be 20 miles away by now.
We can track them that far if we need to. Depends on how much you want to find him.
Yeah. I still ain't sure about that.
What are you getting off for?
Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen him? We're looking for our friend.
I don't think he's here.
You seen a strange sort of feller? Sort of formal?
Strange? Sure. Formal? Nah.
He uses a cane. Looks a lot like this one.
Yeah. All right, you two.
Where the hell is he?
You both better get out of here!
Come here!
You stay there.
Where is Trelawney?
I don't know anything.
Tell me where he is.
You go to hell.
Better tell me now, you son of a bitch.
Okay, okay, for Christ's sake. I took him to a cabin over by the cornfields.
Which cornfields?
Left. Down the path there by Braithwaite Manor.
Let me see you again, you hear me?
You got lucky there, my friend.
Come on, let's go.
Follow me. I think there's a way around so we don't have to go through the Braithwaite place.
Yes. I've spent enough time there. After you, though.
Easy. You okay?
I'm good.
What do you think they want with Trelawney?
Could be any one of 100 things. Just depends if any of them involve us.
You think he'll talk?
Of course he'll talk. He'd sell his own sister to save a train fare. He don't know how not to talk. He don't know where we're holed up, though. At least I don't think he does.
I don't know why Dutch still deals with him. Always disappearing for weeks on end.
He's got his uses. And, well, loyalty matters to Dutch.
Of course. But is Trelawney loyal?
Kind of. I guess Trelawney ain't exactly disloyal. Just got a big mouth. Don't worry. If he talked, I'll goddamn find out what he said. Nothing's ever straightforward where Trelawney's involved. Learn that much.
I mean, how much time have we wasted getting this fool out of trouble?
He somehow manages to be both lucky and unlucky at the same time.
Yeah, that's one way of looking at it.
but he always finds some way to pay us back. Just when we think about cutting him loose, he brings us something big. I guess that's his special talent, keeping fish on the line. Must be it.
Hold. Let's get you out of here. Come on, boy.
The thing is, after that sack, this will be remembered like a good time.
Put the man down, gentlemen. That the lot of them?
I think so.
So you're alive.
Allegedly. Look, go get them out. I can handle this.
Don't let him get away. Could have told anything.
Quick, find them. They're trying to hide in the fields.
Look at the bird. Go that way.
Quit that. No, don't do that. Why are you doing that?
We got one more, Charles.
Right, there are three of them.
Get after him!
back for Trelawney.
That was probably the oh my gosh.
Never goes easy,
I absolutely took that guy out, dude.
Come on. Let's go see how badly they beat up the slippery fella.
I wonder how much trouble he's brought with him.
Guess we'll soon find out.
Seems like we can't catch a break now, Arthur.
Our luck's held this long. We got out of worse scrapes than this one.
So I heard.
Sure. What's government agents and bounty hunters do us?
Right.
Mr. Trelawney, where are you?
Over here, dear boy.
Well, he's still here at least. Put your feet up, why don't you?
You okay?
Never finer.
So, who was they?
They were bounty hunter. Attached to Cole Stoudemire.
Okay.
They weren't looking for me,
per se. What'd you tell them?
Not much. I told them I was an intellectual. Come down here from Oregon, looking for a job at the university. Of course, they didn't believe me. Seems you stirred up quite a hornet's nest in Blackwater.
So I keep here.
It might be best if I stay with you, gentlemen, for a while. Can't go back to that caravan now.
All right, Charles. You take Trelawney back to camp. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
It always seems to be more and more civilization. I want to get back in the open country of the West, or what's left of it, but well, even that ain't the way I remember it.
Look at that. What other missions we got? So we got John, Trelawney, and Bill. Okay.